Like that.
Four, three.
People out there. Welcome to the show known as Conversations in Monrovia. Live edition covering Corona 19. Yes, it is still going on. We're still in the extremely dangerous period, believe it or not. I'm honored to have here in the studio Tom Adams, Mayor of Monrovia, California, and the President of Monrovia Unified School District, Rob Hammond. I got it right this time?
Did it good.
All right. To the viewers out there, if you've been following the show, we appreciate the call-ins that's been coming through. We appreciate that. How long will this be taking place? I don't have a clue. But I know every day something happens. Every day there's new information. And sometimes even the President of the United States will take a step back to say, no, Easter time will not be a celebration of it's the end of this virus, this war that we engaged in. All right, Tom, can you give the viewers out there an update on what's going on in the city of Monrovia?
I can, and Ralph, once again, thanks to you and the KGEM crew. This is such an important way of getting information out to the community. We appreciate it. Tonight, we will have a special city council meeting. Our next regularly scheduled meeting will be April 7th, but tonight we're having a special meeting just on COVID-19 and a lot of the changes that are taking place. And we are
not open to the public.
Well, it is open. So as Rob mentioned at our last show, the state has changed the Brown Act rules for public meeting, and people will not physically be allowed to be at the meeting. None of the council will physically be at the meeting.
Oh, okay.
We're going to be meeting by way of Zoom, so it will be a virtual meeting, which is now legally allowed because of the problem we're all facing. So tonight we will be meeting by Zoom. The public can submit their comments electronically to the city clerk, and that's cityclerk@ci.monrovia.ca.us.
Mm-hmm.
And those will be read into the record and submitted, and the council will hear all the comments. But several of the things we're going to be doing, one is kicking back the closure of so many of our buildings to the end of April now. I think we all know this is not going to be over today.
Right.
So
right.
We're kicking it out a month. So we'll be discussing that. We're looking at a variety of things we can do to try to help business kind of relax some of the rules,
mm-hmm,
of putting up banners, putting signs out on the sidewalk, as long as they can maintain ADA width,
mm-hmm,
for wheelchair access, etc. Changing a lot of those. We're trying to see what we can do to make the community work a little better and try to make it less cumbersome.
So if people listen to the directives that the city gives out, things can happen to help business, right? If
oh,
they
absolutely.
Say stay this amount of distance,
yes.
Listen, if the skate park is closed, don't climb over the fence.
Well, and we are having a problem with that, not just in the skate park, but the county issued an order to close all of the trails and all of the parks. So that includes the trails that work along the wash. So we went out and put up closure signs and taped them all off, and people are now taking those down and doing.
I was gonna ask the silly question, but no question is really silly.
No.
You're taking away my rights. You don't have the right to do that.
Well, it's like, what's that old saying about yelling fire in a movie theater? You're putting other people's lives at risk.
Mm-hmm.
So on one hand, you have freedom of speech. On the other hand, you don't have the freedom to create an atmosphere that is harmful to other people. So the county health department has the legal authority to issue these orders.
Mm-hmm.
And then we do our best to enforce them.
Which is putting a tremendous force on the police department when they have other things they need to be doing.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. The police department has a lot of challenges that they're facing right now. we shouldn't have to have them chasing people who don't want to follow the rules about the trails. It's like, come on.
Any other changes taking place?
We're going to be discussing the eviction rules. As you know, the county came out with one set, the state came out with a different set. The state is statewide, the counties was only to the unincorporated areas. So the interesting thing on the eviction moratorium is the state has issued a 60-day stay on that. The courts are closed for 60 days anyways. Mm-hmm. By the time a backlog gets around, it might be 90 or 120 mm-hmm. days before that happens. One of the arguments is the state moratorium is only for residential and doesn't impact commercial.
Oh, wow.
And I think the reason for that is that if you look historically at consumer protection laws, are they designed to protect consumers, mm-hmm. not business owners.
Okay.
So,
that means business owners out on a limb in a sense, right?
What it does is it tells business owners and the person who owns the building that the business is in, you guys go work this out.
Okay.
Use some common sense. I don't know a landlord today that wants to get rid of anybody.
Right.
You can't replace them.
Right.
So why would you? There might be some landlords that take advantage of the situation. Mm-hmm. There might be some tenants that take advantage of the mm-hmm. situation. We're going to try to get everyone to see if we can't all get along mm-hmm. and do the right thing for people, because a lot of people are hurting today.
Big time.
And they're going to be hurting more in
down
a couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Anything else?
I'll defer to Rob. He's okay. got some great news.
Good.
Tell me, we got good news?
The lunch program. I was involved in a teleconference with the Rotary Club today, and Rob couldn't attend, but I was so proud to say that the cafeteria workers at the Monrovia Unified School District, even though this is spring break week,
yes.
have volunteered to work to make sure that kids get fed.
Yeah. I got the applause.
Well, that's amazing.
Okay.
Because you take a group of children who have grown up relying on their schools
yes.
for breakfast or lunch,
both.
You can't just pull that out from under them.
Oh, yes.
So everyone's, this is what Monrovia is about.
Yes, good.
Yeah.
Rob.
Yes, sir.
You got the lowdown. Tell the viewers out there.
We have not been as busy as the city this week because, of course, we were closing on Friday, and Tom has this big meeting tonight. It is a large issue on what to do with rents, and I know there's a good city council there, mm-hmm. and they will come up with the thing that makes the most sense for this community. We've uncovered another problem.
Another challenge.
This one's a problem.
Okay,
it's a challenge problem? When it when it belongs to somebody else. It's a problem when it's yours.
Okay.
So we have a problem.
Okay.
If you remember, we had the conversation about doing classroom learning remotely.
Oh yes.
We, for everybody who has a device, who has Wi-Fi, who has connectivity, mm-hmm. you're fine. Giggle and Spectrum stepped up in a big way and offered 60 days to people who were not even their customer to take their service so that they could get their school, okay? Frontier, who is located over off of Primrose, has never offered a program to help people. Theirs is, that's not the business that they're in.
Helping?
I don't know, I can't.
I said it.
So there's a gap. And so wherever that gap is that we can't get where Giggle and where Spectrum can provide the service, we have a hole in our network, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
So the school district is currently buying hotspots so that we can get internet connectivity inside of a person's home that does not have a Wi-Fi. We're providing the tablet, Chromebook, but it doesn't have the ability to create its own hotspot. So we currently purchased 20. We are looking, we need about 25 more. So if anybody knows where we can get some hotspots, we would appreciate knowing where to go get them, because we're a little short right now. And we're fine this week, but we're going to have a problem come Monday. And as Tom just said, we are now looking to the end of the month. We were already going to September, May the 5th, so we need to provide for that. And I'm going to go out on a limb. I think maybe May the 5th may be not the right date either.
Yeah.
And if that's the case, then we need to prepare to how to get through the end of the school year. Right now, there's so many moving parts, we don't know. So you're trying to stay two steps ahead of what's out there.
Day by day.
And so this is what we see. We have a problem, like to get it resolved before Monday. We are calling everybody who are in the transmission business of, where do I get a hotspot? And that's one of the biggest issues that we're facing right now, is to get that in the hands of the people who need it so they can be back in the classroom starting Monday.
Frontier, there's a call out there for you. Seize the moment.
And food, always going to be an issue, is food. We have now, we're reaching out to other vendors besides just how we get food in the school district. Some people may have read that there was an issue in Pasadena with a food service worker. If something were to happen that would crimp our ability to produce food, we would need to be able to get food and still get it out. So we're working on another way of securing food.
Backup plan.
And maybe even the backup to the backup.
You gotta have it.
So right now, we are sitting there and we're fine. We're fine. We have our food service group has done a fantastic job, up to and including what Tom was just saying. This is their vacation. They were not scheduled to work this week. And they're there in the morning preparing those two meals so that they can deliver it between 9 and 11 o'clock in the morning. This will go on all week long.
What if someone wants to become a part of that team? Who would they contact?
Well, they're actually school district employees.
Oh, wow.
So these are people who let their vacation time go to come in to serve our kids. I mean, it is a selfless act.
That's amazing.
That it's to be applauded. It really is. And when all this is over, the list of people that you're going to have to thank.
Endless.
We're going to kill a tree writing out certificates. Yes. I can guarantee it.
Absolutely.
Endless.
And so we have that. That is a big deal. And it cannot go understated how big a deal it is for employees of we're the largest employer in the city, the school district is. And this is a group of people that said, no, what we're doing is too important to take a vacation, and we're going to come into work. Incredible.
All right, I think we have some questions out there. David?
Yes, we have a Monrovia freshman, Chris. He likes the flexibility, but he misses the social aspect of school. And he wanted to know whether he's going to get back to school. That was his question.
Chris, that is a great question, and one I wish I could give you the answer to. And I can't tell you because I don't know. The moving target is such that I don't think there's a person in a position of any authority in the entire country that knows the date that we're going to be okay.
Nobody knows.
What I will tell you, Chris, is this. I know it's tough. And especially being a freshman. You have everything going right now, and you want to get out and do things with your friends. Do it on the computer. Do not do it in person. Don't get together with your friends. The life that you may save by not getting together with your friends could be a person in your own home.
Yeah.
Don't do it. Resist the urge to impetuously get together for a few minutes of a good time. It just won't be worth it if somebody in your family were to get sick.
So take on that challenge, because it truly is a challenge to refrain.
Yeah, there's a lot of video tournaments going on right now that are free. Get involved in those. You can go out in your own driveway and shoot hoops, yeah. But going on to that, all of our school grounds are closed to all outside activity. There is nobody allowed on school grounds now for any kind of recreation. Years ago, the city and the schools partnered with the school property mm-hmm. as an extension of parks in the community. That has been rescinded for right now. Mm-hmm. There is no activity allowed on school grounds as it pertains to it being a park. There are still some employees that come, not very many. We're looking at scaling back as many people as absolutely possible on our school grounds. Administrators have all been asked to work from home, even though we are essential. Mm-hmm. If it can be done away from the campus, let's do it. We will even start scaling back our custodial people.
Oh, okay.
Anything to keep people off the roads, yes. out of doing whatever it is that we do when we get out. I know the freedom I feel like you get up in the morning and going someplace, even just coming to the studio.
Right.
It's like, man, these four walls get really close together. But I think that we have a lot longer to go before we're able to realize being out. I would like to say something about that. A lot of us don't know, myself included, what sacrifice really is. Mm. We've had it good, and I think we in this country have it really good most of the time.
Big time.
Yet we're being asked to do something now that we're not really, and I think that's the resistance to it, which is you're asking to give something up voluntarily. Mm. And it's your free time is what you're asking to be given up. And to do the extracurriculars that we just take for granted, which is, I think I'll get on my bike. I think I'll get on my skateboard. I think I'll just go to name the place. That we cannot do. The sacrifice now is the personal sacrifice of thinking that you don't want to hurt another human being because you don't know is if you're infected or not. You just don't know.
Right.
And you could be and give it to somebody else. The thing that we have to remind ourselves is a lot of people will get sick. Just because you don't didn't mean that you didn't get somebody else sick.
Mm-hmm.
Stay away from people. It's right. The most important thing.
And then you can always watch on television in neighboring states and see the impact of what's taking place. New York is no joke. Mm. That's for real. Louisiana, no joke, is for real. Florida might be on the way. So this is no joke. This is the real thing going on. And listening to wisdom is the key thing. Refrain. If you have to stay in, hey, that's what it's all about.
I will tell you, my brother, who recently retired as a captain in the CHP, mm-hmm. he was picked up by a firm to hired by a firm. Picked up sounds
right. Yeah, yeah.
Hired by a firm. They are securing facilities right now in San Francisco in ballrooms in vacant hotels, big hotels, to act as triage and hospital rooms for people who are sick. This is not a joke. He sent me some pictures this morning of their triage areas, and there must have been 300 beds in this one ballroom. Yes, this is not a joke. The preparation is for people to be sick and get isolated away from other people.
Now they,
hopefully it never comes to pass.
Right, right. Well, but, I heard in Pomona, the Sheraton.
Right, at the fairgrounds.
Yeah,
right.
That they have 19 people or 16 people already are there.
Right.
That's just the beginning.
But the good news is between the Navy hospital ship, the hospital that's being set up at the Coliseum, all of the other locations, and it's not that COVID-19 kills so many people, but what it does is it overwhelms yeah. our health system to the point that when you fall down and break your arm, you can't get in because it's full. That when you have a heart attack or a stroke or your kidneys start to fail, mm-hmm. any of the things that health people deal with on a regular basis, the system is so jumbled up with COVID-19 that you can't get any medicals. That's why they're setting up all these other locations. But you know, I woke up this morning and my wife and I were talking. We have a friend who just had their teenage daughter put in a medically induced coma.
Ooh.
and things don't look good for her. And then we were watching the news with all of the tornado damage. And we looked at each other and said, you know, we really don't have a problem. Our life is still very good. And I think we need to keep our eye on the ball. And if we all do the right thing, and that doesn't include jumping the fence at the schools so you can do a pickup basketball game, or jumping the fence on the trails so you can hang out with your friends.
Or jump the fence and break your leg. And
exactly.
Then
if we all do the right thing, we'll get through this. But it's going to take time. And I think Rob's right. I don't know that the end of April is the magic day.
So those, the frontline defense, those doctors, those nurses, the fire department, the police department, all those people, what's going to happen when they got to get weary and tired? I mean, day after day after day. I have a daughter that works at a hospital in Torrance. And she tells how overwhelmed they are. I mean, that with masks, with gloves, with hand sanitizer, everything is like full capacity, not like every other day, but every day. Now, she's in nursing delivery. People still gonna be giving
birth
to babies.
You bet.
That's right, and it's like, wow. You know, yes.
But the good news locally, and you saw the chief today,
yes.
The police chief tells us that all of our first responders,
yes,
police, fire, everybody's fine.
Good.
They're taking this in stride. They're doing all the right things. They're protecting themselves. And although I don't know, we don't know where the four cases are in Monrovia, apparently our first responders at least know the address so that if they get a call to go to that location, they can suit up and to protect them. So from that standpoint, Monrovia, I am so amazingly proud of how Monrovians are pulling together to help each other, and I see more examples of that every day.
And following directions as best they can. David, another question out there.
How is the city recommending and supporting restaurants that don't want to close and are trying to follow social distancing procedures? Is there a best practice for selling, preparing, and giving out food?
Well, restaurants are under LA County Health Department order to close for everything except takeout and delivery, to the point that you can't even sit down inside the restaurant while you're waiting for your order. And if there's any violations of that, that's enforced by our police department.
So it's pick up and go. It's not
pick
sit
and
down
go.
And I'll wait for it.
Not even sit down while you're waiting. Nothing. It's all delivery or takeout, 100%. If you see any violations of that, call the police department. That's what they do.
Another question?
How is the high school supporting current juniors who should be preparing to apply for colleges right now?
It's a good question. Right now, obviously, everybody's on spring break. I want to make sure I give the right information. All the scheduling for next year's, which are the seniors graduating, it's the juniors. I'm sorry, I'm processing this question at the same time taking it through. The tests, the sign requirements have all been extended, I think, 60 days. Everything has been extended or put on hold except for our can't think of the name.
So what's the contact
I'll get
number
in a second.
If someone wanted to call
anything
in
with the school district, 626-471-2000. AP courses, AP testing will go on. We have not heard that it will stop, that not hit its mark in May of early May of this year is when AP testing is going to take place.
Wow.
So if you're in the AP class, stay on your stuff. It will not include material that would have been covered from, I think, March the 6th to now, but it will cover everything from
back
up to March the 6th.
Okay.
So that's important. That was the only one that I am not aware of as being changed. Everything else has been moved. If you're preparing to go to college and you want to get your letters out, get your letters out to the colleges that you want to go to, we're all going to be in the same boat.
Yeah.
It's not going to be like the folks from Monrovia are like, oh my gosh, you know, we got left
we're
out.
We're behind.
Get in line.
This is everybody's going to be in it.
Get in line.
The SATs and they've all been extended. So mm-hmm. that is not going to be an issue.
Now, do you think as an educator, do you think that this situation with the schools is going to change the educational process in America?
I can guarantee it's going to. There's no doubt in my mind. What used to be the way that was taught will not be the way it's taught in the future. I want to go, not all is rosy here, mm-hmm. okay? The online environment is not a great environment. Especially it's not a great environment when it's one that you wish you would have had a semester to try out. We've been training in Google Classrooms, but Google Classroom never foresaw the teacher not in front of students.
Right.
So we have now removed one of the most important equations in a classroom. It's the teacher.
And
I want to say this, not every teacher is alike. There's a reason why when you think in your mind and you draw upon that one teacher or two that you had that were just stellar.
Yes. Just made a difference.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You didn't recall, let's see, 6 times 4, 24. You didn't recall 32 teachers that you had in high school. You could probably name two. Okay. So all teachers are not the same. Now, there are those that rise to the occasion mm-hmm. and make the online experience a great experience.
Because that's their calling.
That is what they do, yeah. And when they were born into this world, they're a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
There are others who do a fine job and do it well.
They might do it with the personal touch in front of the classroom.
And then there are some that it's like, it's harder to do it than the others.
Yes, like I didn't ask for this, but it's upon me.
Right.
And I have to do it.
So we're learning too. So, but I guarantee that this environment, right now we are in contact with universities mm-hmm. who do distant education all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So we're learning so that we can give this information for best practices to our teachers and our administrators. We need to learn fast. It's not just as easy as here's your Chromebook, turn it on, and here's a lesson. That is not teaching.
Mm-hmm.
It's very difficult. So it's, but I know for certain that once this gets learned,
mm-hmm.
going back to the old ways will not be an option.
Mm-hmm.
The horse and carriage is now gone and being replaced by an automobile.
Yeah.
It just is. And there's some simple things. From now on, you will not be absent from school ever. You don't need to be.
That's right.
You will have your full lesson right here, complete with a teacher who's in front of you.
Mm.
It's there. We can do that. What we cannot do and do it well yet is that direct communication of a give and take between a student and a teacher. That is lacking, and we're not there yet. I don't know that anybody's there yet.
Mm-hmm.
I know for certain that we are not there yet.
But the road is open and we're headed that way.
It's yes, like saying the driverless car is coming. It will get here.
Mm-hmm.
We're not there just yet. And it's critical, especially in a platform where you're in a classroom and you have questions.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lag between a question and an answer.
Yeah, because as I recall, in the classroom, other students can create questions for you that you may not be able to articulate, but because
right.
they're in that classroom and they ask the question, you get your answer in your mind working.
And it adds to the experience.
Yes, yeah. Yes, yes. David, another question?
Ralph's Grocery Store is installing plexiglass. Any plans or local mandates to add more protection for grocery store checkers?
That's everywhere. I think that's part of the supermarket network.
It is. And they're doing an incredible job of mandating the social distancing. So it's so funny, you drive by the grocery store and if you see a line outside, that doesn't mean that there's no room inside.
Right.
What that means is they're only allowing so many people in at a time, and they've got the 6-foot tape measured out on the floor throughout the store, and they're really doing a great job.
It's late, but it's happening now.
And it's not only at the grocery stores, but at the banks.
Oh, yeah.
And a friend of mine was at the bank this morning, and someone started to sneak past where they were supposed to be. And one of the employees of the bank told them to step back, and the customer gave them a little bit of a hard time. And they explained, this is the rule, and you either step back or we call the police department to have you removed.
You'll step forward, but it won't be going to the bank.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. And those people working in the supermarket, that's like unreal. Every day, handling cash. Some stores are not taking cash. You can use your car,
right?
But they won't take cash.
Well, and you get back to, now that they've got the
shield.
The shield to protect them, it's like when we arrived here, Rob and I walked up, the door was open for us. We walked in and sanitized our hands. And we came in and we sat down, we didn't touch anything, and when we go to leave, we'll sanitize our hands and then we'll go on about our business.
And we do have.
And we do have that.
Okay. But this is another story here, but go ahead.
I know, but if we all just do the right thing.
Yes.
And it's not that difficult. It truly isn't that
difficult. It's just a challenge that we have to step up to.
Part of it's changing our ways.
Oh, yes.
You know, we all have our habits in life.
Mm-hmm.
And we like to do things the way we've always done them, and this creates a challenge.
And it's every day. It's not like tomorrow we don't have to do this anymore.
No, it's going to be for a while. Yeah.
Question, David.
There's been people out in the park, and there's some people look like they're exercising, some people are congregating, playing games. How can you tell the difference, and who's allowed to be there and not?
So, every level of government encourages people to get some fresh air and exercise by yourself. What you're not supposed to do is do it with others. Now, my wife and I, and I think the rule, the phrase in the rule is intimate partners. So we touch everything together, at home, ourselves, and so if you saw her and I walking down the street holding hands, that wouldn't be uncommon.
Mm-hmm.
If you see Rob and I walking down the street holding hands, that would be violating the social distancing, right?
It's here where I'd normally make a joke, but I'm not going to.
But so, you know, if there's people participating in group activities, that's not allowed.
Okay.
It's not allowed. But neither does any level of government expect people to never go outside. And we can't close the sidewalks.
Mm.
But walk by yourself.
Yeah. I guess you said it all right there. Walk by yourself.
And take your dog for a walk.
Yeah.
The dog needs exercise too.
Mm-hmm. Another question, David?
This is regarding Channel 5 today. If you see violations about businesses not following guidelines, to call the local city hall first. They're just asking if that's something that we're practicing here.
You did say call.
Yeah. Well, call the police department. Keep in mind that these orders, and they're orders, these aren't recommendations, but the multitude of the things that we follow are the LA County Health Department orders. And they're enforced by, in this case, the Monrovia Police Department. Although the health department has inspectors going around checking food establishments, but for things like park closures and trail closures and things like that, that's a police function.
Are schools extending counseling services for the students, and how's the school accounting for students' well-being in terms of mental health?
The answer to that is yes, please. I covered this last segment. I had a lot of phone numbers. If you did not see that, you can go back and watch the previous segment. There were a lot of phone numbers that were given for individual organizations. If you do not care to do that, you can call the school district at area code 626-471-2000. There's nobody to answer the phones today because the school district is closed because we're on spring break. So that's why I'd encourage you to go back in and watch it was the episode just before this.
Okay.
I gave a lot of phone numbers for that very issue about us supporting students and their mental health.
Okay.
And how to help parents help their students.
Yes.
Because now a lot of parents are being given the role of not just parent, but as
teacher.
Educator.
Yes.
And it's not a role that we were all made for.
Mm-hmm. Different discipline. It goes with motherhood, fatherhood, and now instructor or teacherhood.
It's tough.
That's amazing. David, any more callers out there?
Is there a plan for the city to temporarily stop or recommend halting rent collection?
Halt what?
Halting rent collection. I guess probably people being foreclosed.
So the city can't pass laws about rent. Mm. What the city can do is follow the state rule, and it is a state of California order at this point that there can be no evictions for the next 60 days on residential properties. As a practical matter, the courts are closed anyways, so there can't be any evictions right now. But there's some things you have to read up on that. You have to have been current on your rent on March 1st. So the person that skipped their rent in January and February and is now saying, hey, wait a minute, COVID-19.
I don't have to pay the
rent. Yeah. And I want to be very careful that people understand you still owe the rent. The rent is still due and payable. All the law is doing is banning the eviction of people who haven't.
So you have almost like a grace period.
You do. And then there's a period of time to make it right and pay it back.
Mm-hmm.
But we can't get involved with what is a contractual relationship mm-hmm. between a landlord and their tenant.
So they need to work it out to avoid any
yes.
litigation, I would
yes.
think, right?
Absolutely. And I'll tell you, if there's some landlords out there that don't think they need to do the right thing, I would not want to be one of them in front of a judge. Because I don't know a judge out there that will look kindly upon someone who thought they were going to push people out during this time.
Adding to the homelessness,
yeah.
which is a big problem
already. We all need to figure it out because yeah. everybody's being impacted by this. The big ones, the small ones, and everybody in between. Everybody's going to suffer a little bit. I think the goal of all of us is to try to keep the suffering to a minimum.
Yes, yeah. Any questions out there? All right, how are we on time? Time to wrap it up. All right, can I go to what took place today?
I was hoping you would.
But wait a minute. What's the three letters they keep saying?
PPE.
PPE. Children, ask your parents, what is PPE? You keep hearing it every time you turn on the television set as we battle this. A virus is part of an army. Army on our side is to have the proper equipment. And that proper equipment is what, Tom?
Personal protection equipment.
Which means?
Face masks, gloves.
Okay. And when you're done with your gloves, some sanitizer, right?
Sanitize after that. But you know, this brings up an amazing point. It was so bad to see this on the news. People go to the grocery store, they pull on some rubber gloves, they go inside and do their shopping, they come out, put their groceries in their car, they peel off the rubber gloves that may be infected, we don't
yes.
know, and they throw them down on the ground.
Right.
It's like, you know, folks, we can do better than this.
Yeah. Whatever happened to don't litter?
Walk That's over to the trash can, peel them off and drop them in the trash, then go get in your car and go home. I go to the store and as soon as I get in the car, I've got a little thing of personal hand sanitizer. I sanitize, and then I go about my business. But you know, littering is not the solution.
Yes,
it just isn't.
I'm going to grab Rob into this.
Yes.
To talk about what happened today in front of the police department in the city of Monrovia.
Today.
California.
Today, a group, an organization that has been in our community for decades,
mm-hmm.
who has never ceased to answer the call for help, showed up today and brought much needed supplies
yeah.
to the school district and to the city in the form of hand sanitizer, masks, and gloves.
Precious items.
These are gold in this environment right now. Mm-hmm. As the hand sanitizer, you have the organization, they made it themselves.
It's surface disinfectant. That's fabulous.
That will clean just about anything right there and not stain your clothes doing it. The Sushi are a fantastic organization. Buddhist Compassionist Relief, reaching out all over the world to make the lives of other people better. Mm-hmm. And they have been such good friends to everybody in this community.
Well, they're a very
small organization, sitting over there on Ivy Avenue in Palm. A lot of folks may not even know they're here. And they have a worldwide outreach.
All right.
Fantastic people.
A different set of Buddhists. And I read this book back in 96. It changed my thought process of those involved with Buddha, which is quite interesting. They're not sitting around just chanting. They're more about action. And they do it in a big way. Your thoughts on today's event?
Well, we were the recipients, the city and the schools, of thousands of masks, mm-hmm. Thousands of gloves, hand sanitizer, surface disinfectant, from a group of people that ask for nothing.
Right.
They just want to help. There's another Buddhist group that's coming into town that contacted me last night and said, what can we do? We have a connection from China for masks. How many do you need? And I said, we'll take all you can get. So they're sending over 2,000.
How many cities wish?
They all do. So I think the Tsuchis showed up with 2,000 masks today. The other group is going to come up with another 2,000. I've been in touch with a lady who has very strong connections in Hong Kong, mm-hmm. and she's coming up with another 2,000. So if we add that on top of the ones that we already had, mm-hmm. we'll be able to not only reach the schools, the fire department, the police department, we can stock the volunteer center and the Unity Center, because these are people that are truly out on the front line.
Yes.
Going to seniors' homes, trying to make sure that they eat.
And the Army is only as good as the equipment that they have.
Absolutely. So this today was a pretty special day.
A great day. Rob, tell the viewers out there about the blood drive.
We are scheduled for April the 8th. City of Hope will be having a blood drive. It will be held at Monrovia High School in room 210. Time is still being worked out for them, not us. We're there 24 hours a day, and so we're waiting on them to have it, but it will be on April the 8th, and please, 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 if you're able to give blood, please do it.
All right, they're telling me it's time to wrap up the show. Go ahead.
If I could just add the City of Hope phone number, 471-7171. There's a critical shortage of blood, and it's not because we have a great demand. It's a lot of people aren't going. Mm-hmm. My wife Sally and I went to City of Hope, Friday, I think, and gave blood. And let me tell you, if anybody knows how to do it correctly and keep everyone mm-hmm. socially distant and disinfected and everything, you can trust the City of Hope.
They give that number out again.
Area code 626-471-7171. The City of Hope knows how to take your blood and to protect you and everyone else at the same time. They need your blood. You can give them the gift of life.
All right, Rob, would you like to close it out with some words to the viewers out there?
I appreciate all the time that folks tune into this. We try to keep it as informative and pertinent as possible relating to Monrovia. Mm-hmm. There is another tool that you can use if you don't want to watch this all the time. Mm-hmm. You can go in and look or listen to an audio recording that will have a synopsis of what the information that I'm bringing forward. It's a school telephone number, and it's area code 626-471-2084, and it will have information about what it is that we talked about.
Good.
So if there's something that you're very specific that you'd like, then you can call back to the school district to ask about it.
Okay, as Chris would say, until the next conversation, pick up a good book and read. If you want to find out more information about Sioux Chief Buddhist Compassionate Relief Organization, here's the book.